Hello, welcome back to Code to Start with Mohammed Fathi. You are here to learn Dart programming language. In the last lecture, we have talked about classes and objects, and the declaring of the class will contains fields, or inside the class will contains fields, getters and setters, constructors, functions or methods. Today I'm gonna talk about the constructor. What is a constructor? A constructor in Dart is a special type of method that run automatically when you instantiate the class to make it simple. Me open the VS Code and here try to make a class. For example, class called student, and this empty class. This is a empty class, nothing in it. Let me instantiate this class using the inside the main. I'm gonna make a variable called s1 equal new student. So here, when this called instantiation, this called instantiation means make an object from the student class. As we have discussed in the last lecture, you can omit or remove the new keyword. This is a class. When you run, nothing will happen. For example, let me run by dart main dot dot dart, nothing will happen. This is called the constructor, and the default constructor. The default constructor will be created by the compiler. Let me override this constructor by make another one. The constructor will the constructor name will be like the class name. So here in this class, the class name is called student. So the constructor will be called student here, and nothing inside this parentheses like this. Note this student, this is called a constructor like this. This is a parentheses called the parentheses of the constructor. Let me open the curly brace. Inside this curly brace, I am gonna print object has created. So let me go here. And if you try to run now, this is a constructor, and the constructor is a special type of method that run automatically when you instantiate the class. So the constructor will run, or this method will be run, and here it will print object is has been created. Let me run by here typing dart main dot dart. It printed object has been created. If you try to make another one, for example, by removing this and removing this, this will work fine. Let me go to run also. Now we have two instance or two objects, and the constructor will run two times, and it will be print object has been created. So the constructor used to what is the job of the constructor? It used to initialize the fields. So let me make it clear by make here two fields, for example, string name and int age. This called the fields. Let me make a comment here. This called fields. So we have two fields, string and name. To initialize this for each student, you must go here and type s1.name equal, for example, Muhammad, and s1.age equal 20, and the initialize the s2. For example, you can go here and s2.name Ali Muhammad, s2.age equal 22. So now I'm initialized the two fields inside the student. Let me try to run here by, for example, print s2 dot age is to dot age like this. So let me run by here. Let me first clear, try to run. It will print name Ali Muhammad and age equal 22. So this is the initializing the fields using the field name here. So I'm gonna use the constructor to initialize this. So let me go to the this constructor and try to pass here two parameter. The first one will be string name, and the second one will be called int age. So let me go here after this or before it. Let me initialize. So I am gonna here you the constructor take an argument or a parameter called name, and it also contains a field called name. So here there will be there is a name conflict. If you try to make this, I wanna make assign this to this. So let me assign the name here, the name attribute or the name field. I'm gonna assign it to, for example, the name argument. So here will be a conflict because there is a name conflict. The same identifier make here, this name is like this. So to differentiate between them, you must make use the this keyword. So the this keyword refer to the instance or the current instance from the this class. So it will be refer to the fields. So this dot name means the name this. It will assign to the input parameter name, and another use this dot age equal age. If for example this is called a, you don't need to use this in this case. You don't need to use the this keyword. You can use age equal a, but let me name it age. It will be age convention to make it age, and make this use this keyword here. It will work fine. So let me print here. So after that to this will the compiler will complain because the student need two argument. The first one is the name. So instead of declaring initializing the fields in two lines, I'm gonna comment this and comment this. And here I am gonna make the initialization. So here the first argument will be the name Ahmed, Muhammad, and age will be, for example, 20. So this will work fine. So let me go here and try to print first. Let me comment this. And here let me try to run s1.name and s1.age. It will work fine. So here I'm gonna create an instance in one line and initialize the fields in the same line. So creating and initializing fields in the object in one line using the constructor. So if you try to run, it will work fine, and print object has been created named equal Ahmed Muhammad, age equal 20. So this is a constructor. There is another way, another syntactic sugar for this creating the constructor. Let me comment this and make it simple using a syntactic sugar way. So let me make a constructor here. It will be the same as the class name student, and it will instead of bus this string name, I'm gonna make this dot name and this dot age this is a constructor. You can, this is a shorthand for the this way. So I am gonna here assign this name to, I will be equal to this. It will be copy the value from here to here, and the copy the value from here to the age. So the name will be assigned from this, and the age will be assigned from this. So let me try to run the same result. Okay, it will be the same result. So let me go to the here, try to make another object var s2 s3 equal student, and here you can pass the name, for example Sarah, Ahmed, and age equal 20. And you can make another method here to print the info, for example print make called info. Inside this I'm gonna print student name equal name, age equal age. So I'm gonna print the name and the age of this object using the info. Here you can print like this s3.info, and it will print the name and age of the student 3. Student name is Sarah Ahmed, and age equal 20. So this is the end of this lecture. Please don't forget to share, subscribe to our YouTube channel.